I'm Nina Dokeva. I work at Wolfram Research in the Numerical Computations Group. I will be talking about the solver extension framework for optimization. And in this talk, I'll start with background information about convex optimization in the Wolfram language and what's new in the modeling language and solvers. Then I'll talk about the plugin method to add new solvers, and I'll show some examples how to use external libraries and methods. So start by quickly reviewing the definition for convex optimization. Basically, we want to minimize convex functions over convex sets. And here in this formulation, the functions f should be convex and h should be affine. Okay, so in order to solve convex problems, we usually want to present them in a conic optimization form, which looks a little bit like linear form, except rather than linear constraints, we have conic linear constraints. For example, when this could be vector inequalities, where each element of the vector on the left-hand side should be greater or equal than zero, or this could be generalized to a number of cones that we have available, including norm cone, semi-definite power, and exponential. So in this version, we have a new superfunction convex optimization that generalizes some of the functions for quasis that we had in the previous versions. And Paritush-Mukasi and Tropnap already talked about parametric and robust optimization, so I'm not going to talk about that. And we have Diod functions, find minimum and then minimize, that can now look for convex optimization problems and try to solve them more efficiently. They will also accept language from convex optimization, such as conic inequalities. Okay, so important aspect of the Wolfram optimization functions is that they serve as a modeling language for solvers. So when you call convex optimization, it will start by analyzing convexity and trying to automatically transform the problem into one of these important quasis. And there are some variations how problem can be classified depending on whether the objective is linear or quadratic and whether the constraints are defined as affine. This is what Wolfram language usually uses for the conic constraints. Or many solvers use the equivalent formulation where the affine part is taken separately into equality constraints, and then we just have a membership constraints. And we call it membership because this conic inequality basically means that the variable is in the cone. Okay, so there is a special case of constraints called quadratic constraints, which are represented in this form. And some solvers support quadratic constraints and others don't. So this is technically not a conic constraint. So if a solver does not transport that, we are going to use Cholesky decomposition to transform this into a norm cone constraint. And then the same can be done with the objective function. So let me give you an example with quadratic constraints. Convex optimization with this quadratic objective and quadratic constraint, assuming that our solver does not support quadratic constraints, we are going to use epigraph transformation to make linear objective and put the quadratic form into the constraints. And then we are going to transform automatically these two constraints into second order constraints. Convex optimization will do this transformation automatically. So these are the norm constraints that it ended up with. And then we can use any solver that supports second order optimization problems to solve that problem. Additionally, if we have a solver that does support quadratically constrained quadratic problems, such as Gurobi, we will not need to do the transformation to second order constraints. We can just pass the quadratic objective at quadratic constraints to that solver and it can decide what to do with them further. So the reason why we sometimes don't want to do this transformation is because it uses Cholesky decomposition that takes some time. So we want to avoid this when possible. And let's say that we want to make sure that Gurobi understands these are quadratic constraints because they can be interpreted either as quadratic or second order. Then we can write them in this XQ, X transpose QX quadratic form by using inactive dot. Okay, so now I'm going to use the plugin method that is used to connect many external solvers, external and internal solvers to the modeling language. So once the equations are processed and once the problem is transformed into a form appropriate for the solvers that we have, then it is solved by a solver that is connected in the following way. So we use register optimization method to connect any new solver, where method is just a string saying what's the name of the method, and then association includes some properties of that method. And I'll start with the main properties, which are the name of the function. We absolutely need to have that. The name of the solve function that is going to implement the method and constraint support. Okay, so let me start by showing an example. Let's try to connect a very simple solver, which we will use find minimum to do as an engine so that the examples can be short enough to fit in the notebook. And we are going to register it by giving the name of the method, which let's say will be find minimum, the name of the solve function which will be find minimum solve, and what type of constraints it is going to support. Let's say we want to support only equality, inequality, and norcom constraints. And the way this method is going to work is by taking conic constraints and transforming them into constraints with regular equalities and inequalities. So instead of this vector inequality and conic inequality, we will turn the constraints into nonlinear constraints with regular inequality. So for example, if we have a norm con constraints here, we are going to write this as x squared plus y squared less or equal than 1 so that we no longer have a conic inequality. And once we transform the constraints, we can give them to find minimum. And find minimum is going to do most of the work for us. And if everything goes well, it will report success status. And it will give us some data object that can be something very simple that just contains information about the minimum value and the solution of the problem. Okay, so once we have finished writing the solve function, we can make rules for the different properties of the solvers. So primal minimum value will be recovered from the solution data in this way. And primal minimizer vector will also be taken from the solution data. It can either be given directly in the solution data or it can be computed in some way. And for any properties that we don't have, we are going to put missing not available. So this is the bare minimum that we need to register a solver. And I'm going to check if this all works. So I will compute these definitions. So when we register a solver, it will reassure us by giving true that the definitions are correct. And then we can try to evaluate conic optimization or any other convex optimization function with the new method that we just registered, find minimum. And it's just going to work. Okay, then if we have some options that find minimum takes, they are going to be automatically sent through. So we can write any option values here inside this method. And here we can, for example, find minimum takes method interior point, which is for the Wolfram language implementation of interior point method. And this is the result. When we use the IPOPT library implementation, it will give a slightly different result. But of course, we can then add tolerance options and that will improve further. Okay, so let me go back to the plugin methods and talk a little bit about the rest of the properties. So we can have sub-methods. We don't have, I mean, we can have just one method as in this example, or in the registration of MOSIC, for example, we have MOSIC primal and MOSIC dual. So we register both and then we say that method MOSIC will call one of these solvers. And how it chooses which solver to call is first it will try the first one. It will look at the properties. If the properties are appropriate for the given problem, it will use the first one. If the first one doesn't have, if say doesn't support some type of constraints, then it will go to the second one. Okay, so other keys in the registration functions are objective support, which can be linear or quadratic or nonlinear. So let's look at the table. Yeah, linear, quadratic, nonlinear. Constraint support, it will tell you which constraints are supported. So it could be just a few of those. We can have all the conic constraints. We could have quadratic constraints or nonlinear constraints. And so we need to say if these constraints are supported in an affine form or in a membership form. So when we can have affine left-hand side, we call this affine constraints. And when the affine left-hand side is taken out in the equality constraints, we only have membership constraints. Okay, and some other properties are extended precision support. So most library solvers only have machine precision, but the solvers that we write in-house are going to have extended precision, and some may even have exact solutions. And of course, we can decide how to handle messages. Do we want to give them right away or suppress them and process them? So there are various options. Okay, so I'm going to continue with the ever-expanding list of external libraries that we have. And I'm going to only talk about the latest ones. So we are adding a quadratic link to the quadratic operator splitting solver for quadratic problems, OSQP. We are adding a link to a new modeling language, CVX, and the Python version of it. And by itself, it can call many additional solvers, some of which we have already linked directly, and others can only be accessed from there for now. We have the commercial external libraries, Mozik and Gurobi. Mozik has, it covers all the cons that we have, and also have has mixed integer variables. It supports mixed integer variables. Gurobi also supports mixed integer variables, and the cons it supports are linear, quadratic, quadratically constrained, and second order con. Quadratically constrained second order as well. So let me illustrate all this with examples. So let's start with an simple investing problem where we decide what kind of expected return we want to have and what's the capital that we are going to put in. And we want to minimize the risk, which is a quadratic function. And here the matrix is very dense, so the timings are not going to be, it's not going to be solved very fast. If we had a sparse matrix, we could solve much larger problems, but let's do this now because we want to see the difference in timings between different solvers. So right now for quadratic problems, the default is CLP. This is part of the coin library, and it is going to get slow for a large number of stocks that we want to consider to invest in. On the other hand, if we use a commercial library, Gurobi, that requires having a license from Gurobi, then it's going to be much faster. But let's say that we don't have a license or we don't want to purchase it, then there are other options. For example, the newly added OSQP solver. It is a low accuracy solver, so by default it will have 3 digits of accuracy and precision. But for this particular problem we don't need anymore, so we can use it instead of the default solver, and we can possibly put it in the performance goal as a default. Okay, so now this is a real this a problem with real valued the variables are real valued. This means that we'll be dealing with fractional amount of stocks. If we want integer valued problems, this becomes a much harder problem. And this is where the commercial libraries now are considerably better. We don't have an open source library for this right now. And we do have some in-house solution, but that's using an outer approximation algorithm. So we'll be adding branch and bound algorithm to make this faster. But for the moment, if we ask commercial library to solve a mixed integer problem, it is probably going to be much faster. So this is how the timing for Gorobi compares with the default method. We can use here Mosaic instead. And this is going to be very fast. Okay, so problem with exponential cons. We can use geometric optimization. Oops, this is supposed to be geometric optimization. Sorry about that. Okay, geometric optimization calls conic optimization with linear and exponential cons. Try to edit this in presentation mode. So let's take the default method for geometric optimization, which is this goes through the open source library SES, and it is not going to be very fast. So this is a problem with linear and exponential cons. And the Mosaic library, which is also a commercial library for which one would need a license to be able to run, is especially efficient and exponential and power cons. So it is going to return a result much faster. And something else that we have, but requires installation of Python, CVXPy, and all these solvers is a link to CVXPy, where you could just point that we want to use the CVXPy solver with CVX modeling language with a given solver, and it will return a result. So except for CVXPy, everything else is installed automatically, and all you need to do to use it is to say what is the method name that you want to use. And for the commercial solvers Mosaic and Gorobi, the libraries will be installed on first use from a Packlet server. For all the open source libraries, they're already in the build, so you don't need internet to get this in your build. But for Mosaic and Gorobi on first use, you need to be connected to the internet to get them. Okay, so I'll conclude with saying that the Wolfram language optimization functions feature a modeling language that provides intuitive and interface for the optimization solvers. And we have in-house solvers and a large variety of open source and commercial external libraries. We'll be adding more. And there is a simple plugin mechanism that anyone can use to add their favorite libraries. Okay, so at this point, I'll take questions. Or we could leave the questions for the meetup that is starting in a few minutes. So at 3:30, there is a meetup for optimization. And let me see. Okay. So let's meet at 3:30 and I'll end my presentation here. Thank you for attending and I hope I'll see some of you soon.